So what is an OCO order in Thinkorswim and how do you use it in your trading? In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to trade with an OCO order so you can streamline your trading. Hey, how's it going? On this channel, you will learn the steps to make a full-time income trading in the stock market. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And at any point in the video, feel free to check out the notes and links in the description below. I'll list out any valuable resources down there. Now today, we are talking about OCO brackets in Thinkorswim. So an OCO order stands for one cancels other. So essentially, if one of the orders gets filled, the other one will get canceled. So generally what these can be used for is a stop loss and a buy limit. So essentially for either cutting your losses in a trade or taking profits. So for an example, if we bought into Apple right here and we wanted to take profits if Apple went up to here, or cut our losses if Apple broke below this level. And so what you would do is then you would place in a OCO order, and if the stock went up here and hit your limit to take your profits, this order down here would get canceled. And then the other way around, if the stock went down here, this order up here would get canceled and you would get stopped out of the trade. One way to enter into these trades is going to the trade tab and then clicking on the price up here and then clicking buy custom, and then you'll see it comes up with OCO bracket. And so this will bring up a trade to then buy shares of Apple and then create that OCO bracket around that to where we can essentially buy in, and then the trade will just run itself and we won't have to do anything. We can have that stop loss or that take profits limit order. And I actually like to do this in the charts so then you can look at it a lot more visually. So we're actually going to go back to charts, but I just wanted to show you this is one way to do it. So back in charts over here, another way to do this and bring this up is right click on the chart, and then again it'll bring up that buy custom, and then we can go over here with OCO bracket. And so I'm just going to change down here. You'll see we have to buy the shares, and then it'll have that OCO order. These two sell orders would be that OCO order. So first I'm going to change this to a market order to buy just so we can make sure we get filled. And then the first order down here, this limit order, is going to be that profit taking order. So if we look up here, maybe we want to take profits when the stock gets up to around 22 or 222. So I'm going to just set this at 222. And so that'll put that limit order for taking profits on this trade up here. And then we can say, oh, maybe we want to have it down here at 220 and a half for our stop loss. So if the stock goes down that far, we want to get out of this trade and not lose any more money. So we're going to change this and then to 220 and a half. And so this will set up this order. And when I send this in, it'll fill us at the market order for these shares. And then we can go in and we can see where these orders will be set up. So I'm going to click and send. Looks like we have enough buying power. So send this order in. Initially, you'll see that order of 100 shares of Apple get filled. And then this order or this OCO bracket pops up. So up here at the top, we have that limit order. And then down here, we have that stop loss order. And so this allows you to then just leave this trade forever and it will do exactly what you set it to do. You have limited risk. You won't get stuck in the trade. If it keeps going down, you'll automatically get closed out and you'll automatically get your profits taken. And then once one of those gets triggered, your other order will get canceled. So you don't have to go in and cancel it. So you don't get filled by that other order by accident, and you're by accident long shares or short shares. So one way you can either change these is you can, if you wanted to move your stop up, you can just click and drag, and then it'll just click with another send box. and then that'll change that order. And again, you can also do this with your limit. You can move your limit up and then resend that, and that'll just change the price of these orders. Another way you could do this is right click on this and it'll come up with copy, cancel, or cancel and replace. And so if you want to go in here and do actual value, like to the cents, this is a better way to do that instead of just clicking and dragging. An easy way to tell that these orders are linked, if you're not sure, is you see this little chain it has next to the amount of shares you have bought. And also it has this little line that goes up the side that shows that it's also linked. If you want to actually cancel these orders, you want to make sure you click cancel OCO group. If you just click cancel order, it'll cancel the single order. So another way to do that is just click X, but this will also just cancel the one order. So if you want to cancel this, you want to make sure you want to click cancel OCO group, and it'll take both of those trades out. Another way to actually put these OCO orders in is actually using the active trader tab. So if I click over here on the right on the active trader tab, it'll bring up this active trader tab, and we can create another OCO order or a buy with an OCO order. So how to do that is you want to click on template and then trigger with bracket. And so this will allow you to buy shares with the OCO bracket order with that, you know, stop loss or that buy limit for taking profits. For Apple here, for this trade, we probably want to have about 50 cents on each side, just for a good example. So we want to change the offset here to 50 cents, and we want to make sure that this stays a negative number for our buy stop. Otherwise, it'll be positive and we might get filled 50 cents above the market right away. So even though on here you can see at the active trader, it says that these triggers look like they're going to be right next to each other. Once you get filled, they'll go to their respective distances. So if I click over here to actually buy, because we want to buy 100 shares, I'm just going to buy 100 shares here, and then that'll get filled potentially. So you can see that this order then, because we haven't got filled on these buying 100 shares, that order will be shown there as well. So you can see we have the 100 shares trying to get filled, and then we also have the stop order as well here. To quickly show you one last thing, if you want to just move this whole bracket up as a whole, essentially trailing up your stop and moving your limit higher, you can drag this gear over here or the link on the side. So if I just click and drag this, you can see that the little bar is moving, and that's where your stops will get moved to. So I can just move these. If I want to move them a little higher, it'll come up with another order, and then that'll send in that new limit order, and you can see it'll be in a different spot. So that's a different way to just change both of them around instead of one individually at a time. Hey, thanks for checking out this video. If you want to learn more about the Thinkorswim platform or just trading in general, make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you have any questions, make sure to ask them in the comments below.